we remain standing as the colours are now brought to the high altar, and I ask the organ to play. I welcome on this his first formal visit to the cathedral, the Most Reverend Wesley Spirer, Bishop of the Roman Catholic Diocese of Hamilton. Bishop Wesley, you're very welcome indeed, and we look forward to many more visits from you in the not too distant future. We greet Mrs. Margaret Ferguson, Honorary President of the Girl Guides here in Bermuda, and with her Karen Trott, the Commissioner of Girl Guiding in Bermuda. We welcome also all former Guiding Island Commissioners, the Executive and Council members. We welcome the Scout Commissioner, Dr. Geoffrey Rothwell.
Eternal God, you have made all things for us, and us for your glory. Sanctify our bodies and souls, our thoughts and intentions, our words and our actions. Let our body be a servant of our mind, and both body and spirit servants of Jesus Christ, that doing all things for your glory here, we may share your glory hereafter. Through the same Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Dear God, dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for waking us up this morning to see a brand new day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice in it and be glad in it. Be with us through this service so that we can reflect and remember why we are here. Help us to make connections with friends both far and near. Be with our sister guides all over the world. Accept our prayer and thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen. We are so glad that all of you have shown up here today. Thank you for your support. Girl Guiding Bermuda is still around, and our aim is to continue on growing. I'm going to share with you for a few moments on what we are all about and how you can get connected. We change as the lives of girls change. We listen to them, we adapt what goes on in our units each week. What makes us unique? We provide support, comfort, and friendships. We build girls' confidence and raise their aspirations. We give them a chance to discover their full potential, and we give them a space to have fun. Girl Guide in Bermuda lets them know that they are part of this wide world and that they can make a difference in it. We provide a safe, non-judgmental environment where girls can learn new skills. We show them how they can speak out and take positive action to improve their lives and the lives of others. We discover, we grow. As our theme this year is Connect, I want to encourage each person here to get connected and stay connected with Girl Guide in Bermuda. We currently have 15 units, 4 guide units, 4 rainbow units, and 7 brownie units. We are looking to reopen the brownie and guide units at St. Patrick's and the rainbow unit at St. Mary's Church Hall. We would love to open a rainbow unit in Sandys. If there are any former Queen's Guides, former Rangers, or anyone in our lovely community who wants to make a difference, who wants to give back or do a good deed, I encourage you to make that step. We always say, I don't have the time, I don't know how to fit it in my busy schedule, I'm already out for 2 nights a week. Guess what? All our volunteer leaders that are operating a unit currently fall into these categories. Just think about it. If we all thought like that, we would not have any unit open today. Thank God for our leaders that we do have. We are all here for your children. We always put the girls first. And you know, moms, we think about ourselves last. This morning, 2 units attended Salvation Army Church in Hamilton. And I had to get up and ask all former brownies, guides, rangers, cubs, and scouts to please stand, because I wanted to see how many people in that church building were part of us. And it was such a warm feeling, because you know, if it was 200 people in the church, 150 stood up to say that they were a brownie, guide, ranger, cub, or scout. And it was so nice to see, because majority of the people in the church stood up. So let's give a little clap to that, because that was really good. I would like to say a great big thank you to all the girls, the parents, and leaders who helped out last week and yesterday with our annual tag day. We do not have the final tally as yet, but when we are complete, we will let you know. And I heard that the girls had a wonderful time and they are looking forward to next year. And some of those rainbows, I tell you, they won the money yesterday. So let's get connected and stay connected to Girl Guide in Bermuda. Let's give back to our community so that we can be around for another 100 years. If you all look on the back of your programs, and usually when we leave this place, those programs are left in the seat. For the girls, you leave your programs in the seat. They will be collected and given to your leaders so that you can have it. But for all our guests and parents, we want you to keep those programs, because there's more information about Girl Guide in Bermuda. You can go to our website. You can send us an email, you can even call me. Connect so that we can share how you can play a vital part in the lives of our young ladies in Brooklyn. Thank you and enjoy the rest of this program.
Wonderful girl guiding colleagues from across the islands. So you're a brave man. Thinking Day, and World Thinking Day in particular, is a very, very powerful way to get a message across. All over the world, on the 22nd of February, Girl Guides and Girl Scouts, Rainbows, Brownies, millions of us, switch our mental phones from silent to on. We expect to send and receive a message. And this year, that message is connect. It's a very simple word, but we can use it to prompt activities that are at the heart of guiding. And I want to suggest three. A connection is a link. It's a way through to someone else. We need to keep connections open and in good repair if we're going to live fulfilled lives, to learn new skills, and to enrich the lives of others. So start with yourself. What do you like doing? What are you good at? What challenge can you set yourself this year that will help you to have something to share with other people? So maybe it's learning to grow something delicious to eat, like strawberries or baby tomatoes. They grow in Bermuda. They grow really easily and they're delicious. Or maybe you're good at something that I'm hopeless at. Maybe you're good at drawing. Maybe you can learn how to do illustrations for posters. Or perhaps you want to learn a skill. Perhaps you want to learn to sew, or maintain a bike, or teach a dance. Whatever it is, aim for one thing and connect with yourself. Then secondly, let's think about us in Bermuda and all the different communities that we're all part of. Family, school, neighborhood, maybe church. So can you make a new community connection this year? Can you do a shared challenge with another youth on a different part of the island? Can you build something together? Put on a show for older people in your neighborhood. Invite your grandparents to talk to you about the Bermuda that they remember and what it was like. For instance, my husband this week went to see a wonderful woman who was celebrating her 100th birthday, Mrs. Williams. She was absolutely on the money. She was way ahead of my husband when I got up, because he asked her rather timidly if she remembered the railway. And she said, come on, I remember it being built. So her memory went way, way back. And those are memories that are part of all of us in Bermuda. I would love to see somebody do a radio program, go and interview people, and let's talk about what Bermuda used to be like. I think it would teach us a lot. And then my third suggestion is to connect worldwide. And possibly the easiest way to do that is to go onto a wonderful website, which is GLOW, G-L-O-W, .WAGS.org. And WAGS, of course, is the Worldwide Association of Girl Guides and Girl Scouts. and they have come up with lots and lots of ideas on ways in which guides all over the world can do things together, can learn from one another, and for this thinking day, of course, can connect. So, for now, I'm looking forward to the rest of this service, when we're going to see here how some of you are taking up that challenge.
I am glad that you explained what the word wives meant, because in my head I was thinking it couldn't have meant wives and girlfriends. So I'm glad that we got the clarification. I hope that you'll now stand with me and join and sing in the wonderful hymn, This Little Light of Mine.
Thank you. connect with me. If we take the time to connect with ourselves and understand what makes us happy and confident, we can make a bigger difference in other people's lives. When we are grounded in who we are able to create lives that are meaningful and fulfilling, knowing our reactions and feelings so we can respond accordingly will help us to take good care of ourselves. It also helps us cope more healthily when tough times arise.
There should be two rainbows that have a piece of the puzzle that we're going to put together this afternoon. Two rainbows that have the pieces. Can you come up?
And friendship is happiness. So what makes a good friend? Connect with someone you care about. Introduce a friend to girl guys and girl scouts and explore the relationships that matter to you. Our most important and powerful connections happen when we're face to face. So make it a priority to stay in touch in the real world, not just online. You get a lot more out of an in-person conversation than you will ever over text or social media comment.
Is something stopping you from building the friendships you'd like to have? Remember that making a friend is just the beginning of the journey into friendship. Friendships take time to form and even more time to deepen. You need to in order to move from acquaintance to close friend, you need to nurture and invest in that new connection. It is a process that requires time, effort, and a genuine interest in the other person. Connect with WAGS, look wider, and connect with the amazing world of girl guiding and girl scouting. Feel like 1 in 10 million. Learn about our global movement and visit a WAGS World Center. Through innovative education and advocacy programs,
Girl Guides and Girl Scouts worldwide learn about the issues affecting their communities and are empowered to speak out and take action. WAG supports girls and young women to develop their full potential as leaders and to activate citizens of the world. Don't just think about WAGs during World Thinking Day, February 22nd. Connect all year long. You will be quite amazed at what you will learn. It's easy to type in WAGs and explore.
Now going to connect with the beauty around us as we stand to sing the hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Go to your child's school and read, share your job skills, etc. but most importantly, see how you can connect with the girl right in you. In order for us to proceed good and strong for generations to come, we need you. Give your time, share your talent, and do a good deed. Get connected, stay connected.
Pray for me. I'm honored to be asked to minister today. I used to remember when this hall was absolutely running over with Girl Guides, Brownies, Rainbows, Cubs, Scouts, and the like. So let's spread the word, let's get connected. The piece I am ministering today, He wants it all. God wants us to connect with Him. He's asking us to get rid of our idols. So we're not making Girl Guiding an idol, but we do make some of our toys, some of our CD, our phones, our iPads, our clothes. So God is asking us to forget about our idols, throw them away, and listen to Him because He loves us and He wants us to give all that we have to Him. So I will minister, He wants it all.
Have the system so
this time, we're going to make a special presentation, and this person has no idea.
Stand to sing. I've got the joy, joy, joy down in my heart, and during the singing of this hymn, a collection will be taken out.
Thank you.
Lord, yours is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all things come from you, and of your own we give you. Amen.
Amen.
Bound together in love and friendship.
to be more loyal to our promise and law, to work and pray for understanding and peace, to serve you more truly in our daily lives. We thank and praise you for the light and vision of our Founder, for his gift of strength to the youth of the world, for Oleg Bailey's public great service to guiding, for the pioneers of guiding in every country, and for all that God has brought to us here. Accept our prayers and thanksgiving. Amen.
Finally, as we go into the world, we are of course connected to one another, to the world, to all these other things, but we also share one other connection made in the image of God. And as we meet in this place, it's good to know that we are connected to Him too, and we ask for His blessing as we go now back into the rest of our days and the rest of our lives. So go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage, hold fast that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Would the congregation please remain seated for the returning of the colors? congregation please stand for the Bermuda National Song.